channel. Today we are going to discuss one of the important special senses, that is the eyes, human eye, that are used for the vision. So let's discuss about the human eye. So what is basically eye? Eye is a sensory organ which is used for the vision. It is located in the orbital cavity of the skull and it is containing the eyeball, which is surrounded by a number of accessory structures. So let's discuss one by one what are the accessory structures. So as you can see here, the first structure is your eyebrows. Eyebrows are what? There are two arcs of the thick skins which are present over the eye, and that is containing the thick hairs. Why the eyebrows are there? What is the use of the eyebrows? They are preventing the dripping of the sweat into the eyes. So these are very useful structures. Then the second structure is your eyelids. Eyelids are what? There are two eyelids. One is your upper and second one is your lower, which is protecting our eye. The upper eyelid is large and they are more mobile, and these upper eyelids are regulated by the muscles, which is your levator palpebrae muscles, which are controlling the eyelids elevation. There are eyelashes also, which are the short hairs which are projecting from the free margins of that eyelids. Then the third structure is your lacrimal apparatus, which is concerned with the production of the tears. There are some muscles which are helping in the movement of eyes, jinko hum bolte hain extrinsic muscles, ya fir you can say extraocular muscles. So there are basically two kinds of muscles, that is straight muscles and oblique muscles. The straight muscles comprised of your superior rectus muscle, inferior rectus muscle, medial rectus and the lateral rectus. These are used for the movement of eyes. If the movement of eye is upward, the muscles which is used is your superior rectus. If the movement of the eye is downward, inferior rectus muscle is used. If the movement of eye is inward, the medial rectus muscle is used. And if there is a movement of eye downwards, the lateral rectus muscles are used. Then coming to the oblique muscles, there are inferior oblique muscles and superior oblique muscles. Inferior oblique muscles helps in the movement of the eyes up and outwards, and superior oblique muscles help in the movement of the eye down and outwards. And this I have already discussed about the levator palpebrae muscles, which is controlling the eyelid elevation and helping in the raising that superior eyelids. So these are your accessory structures of the eyes. Once again I am repeating it, starting with the eyebrows, the two thick arc which is containing the thick hairs, which is helping in preventing the dripping of the sweat into the eyes. Then there are eyelids, upper eyelid and lower eyelids, lacrimal apparatus which is concerned with the production of the tear, and then there are extraocular muscles that are your straight muscles, oblique muscles and levator palpebrae muscles. Now coming to the eyeball structure. Eyeball is a spherical organ which is compromising of the structures that are responsible for the vision. So one by one we are going to discuss each one of them. So basically these are divided into the three layers: outer, middle and inner. The outer layer is made up of your fibrous layer. It is containing our sclera and the cornea structures. What is sclera? Sclera is majorly compromising our most of the outermost layer, that is it is compromising the 85% of that layer only. It is visible as the white part of that. You can see in your eyes, the white part is the sclera. Now coming to the next point, sclera provides the attachment to the extraocular muscles and it also helps in maintaining the shape of the eyeball. Here you can see this outermost layer is your sclera. Now coming to the second structure, that is your cornea. Cornea is what? It is the transparent structure of the eye, which is where it is located. It is located centrally at the front of the eye. Basically what is cornea? It is the entrance window for the light which is entering into the eye. The main function of cornea is to refract that light. So this compromised of your fibrous layer, one is your sclera, second one is cornea. Here you can see this one is your sclera and this part is your cornea. Now coming to the second layer, which is your middle layer, or you can say vascular layer. It is lying underneath that fibrous layer. What structures it is composing of? It is composing of your choroid, ciliary body and iris. Here you can see iris, this blue colored part, Choroid is the second layer and the ciliary bodies. Now we'll discuss it one by one. Choroid. Choroid is what? It is thin, pigmented, highly vascular membrane which is lying between which two layers? Between your sclera and retina. So this layer is your choroid layer. It is providing what? It is providing the nourishment to the outer layer. Now coming to the ciliary bodies. Ciliary bodies is basically comprised of two parts. One is your ciliary muscles and second one is your ciliary processes. So these muscles are collection of some smooth muscle fibers and these are attached to the lenses of the eye by that ciliary processes. Then the third part is your iris. Iris is what? Hamari aankhon mein jo colored portion hai, jo colored ball hai, jisko hum log bolte hain iris. So this iris is a circular structure which is situated between the lens and the cornea and it is a pigmented membrane. The color of the eye is your iris aur us color ke beech mein hamara ek black color ka hole like structure hai jisko hum pupil bolte hain. So here you can see black color se jo layer hai that is your sclera, red one is your choroid and green one is your retina. I hope these structures are clear to all of you. Now coming to the third layer, that is your inner layer. Inner layer is what? It is the innermost layer of the eye. So this layer is formed by the retina. So हम लोग जब आए लाइट जब एंटर करती है आईज में तो हमारा जहाँ पे इमेज फॉर्मेशन होता है वो साइट कौन सी है? दैट इज योर इनर मोस्ट लेयर, दैट इज द रेटिना. सो रेटिना इज द इमेज फॉर्मेशन साइट. रेटिना इज योर इनर मोस्ट नर्वस कोट ऑफ आईबॉल विच लाई डीपर टू दैट कोरोइड लेयर. इट इज consisting of the photoreceptor cells. These are known as your rods and cones. There are around 120 million rod cells are present and about 6 to 7 million cone cells are present. Now what is the function of the rod and the cone cells? These rod cells are your light sensors. They detect the black, white and the shades of the gray. They are basically responsible for the night vision as they work in the less intense light. And what is the function of the cones? Cones are highly active at your higher light levels, like for detecting the bright colors. The categories are blue, red and green colors. So rods are 120 million rod cells are there and about 7 million cone cells are there. Now coming to the optic disc. Optic disc is what? It is the region from where the optic nerve leaves your eyeball. There are two things, two structures. One is your macula, second one is your fovea centralis. Here you can see it is present on which layer? On the innermost layer, that is the retina. Macula jahan par present hai uske beech mein ek depression kind of a thing hai. That depression is known as your fovea centralis. So what is the location of the macula? Macula is the area which is situated just lateral to the entrance of the optic nerve and it is yellowish in color. This deep depression in macula is known as the fovea centralis and this depression is concentrated for the highly your light detecting cells are there in this depression. So I hope it is clear. These both are present on the innermost layer, that is your retina. And what is the function? It is mainly concerned with your light detecting cells, fovea centralis. Then coming to the lens, lens is present behind your iris and pupil. Lens ka kaam kya hai? Light ko focus karna, pupil ke through kahan pe le jana? Hamare retina pe le jana aur wahan pe jaake image ko form karwana. Then image form होने के बाद हमारे optic nerves के through हमारे impulses जो हैं brain में send हो जाएंगे जहाँ पे हमारी image perceived हो जाएगी. There are around 12 cranial nerves. Among them the second cranial nerve which is known as your optic nerve which is responsible for your impulse transmission to the brain and the vision. Now there are two things. One is your aqueous humor, second one is your vitreous humor. What is the function of these two humors or what is the difference? Discussing the first, that is your aqueous humor. Here you can see I marked the aqueous humor. This aqueous humor is a fluid which is present in both the anterior and the posterior chambers of the eyes. This humor is basically helping in nourishing or protecting the eye. And the vitreous humor is the humor or the fluid which is present between the lens and the retina and it is maintaining the shape of the eye, keeping the retina in contact with the choroid and the sclera. And then the last is your optic nerve, which is carrying the impulses towards the brain. So I have discussed about all the accessory structures of the eye, the eyeball, and your the diagram of this eye. Once again, I am summarizing quickly, starting from the eyeball. There are three layers. One is the outermost fibrous layer, which is consisting of your sclera, cornea. Second one is the middle layer, which is your vascular layer. Which is consisting of your choroid, ciliary bodies, and iris. Then the innermost layer is your retina. Here you can see the black layer is your sclera, red one is your choroid, and green one is your retina. And in front there is iris, here is lens, cornea, ciliary bodies, aqueous humor, vitreous humor, and these are your optic nerves which are taking the impulses towards the brain. So what can be the important questions like, how many rod cells are there, how many cone cells are there, what is the function of the vitreous humor and aqueous humor, what are the accessory structures of the eyes. So accessory structures are eyebrows, eyelids, lacrimal apparatus, and your extrinsic or extraocular muscles of the eye. I hope I have made easy to understand all of you about human eye. In case you are having any doubt, you can ask in the chat box. Thank you so much.